Hey guys, it's Lauren. Right off the bat, this is my editing Instagram and you should go follow it if you don't already. So today's video has been highly requested for weeks and I'm so happy to finally do it. Today is gonna be a collab with the lovely and talented Vivian Chi. If you don't know who she is a fellow YouTuber who's also an After Effects editor. And like me, she posts editing related content here on YouTube and also edits on Instagram. So if you like my channel and the content I post on here, I definitely recommend subscribing to Vivian because we have a lot of similar concepts, kind of the same initiatives with our accounts, and she's just super talented and I'm so glad we got together to do this. And today we are going to do a style swap. So over on her channel, she's doing a video where she replicates my style, and today I'm gonna try to replicate her style. Let's get right into it. So first I'm just gonna stalk her account and kind of get a sense for her style. So from what I'm watching, she has a ton of really, really cool backgrounds. They're very detailed, very bright. She does a lot of really cool shakes and warps that look super smooth. I think she has a lot of big transitions. I believe her position scale rotation values are definitely larger than mine, so that's something I should keep in mind. She has a lot of transitions that slide into the screen, that pop up from the screen. I'd say her style is very aesthetically pleasing. She has super nice Twixer settings. And she has some really, really nice 3D accents that I'm gonna try to create. I just get a very happy, bubbly, like upbeat vibe from all of her videos. So let's try to translate that into my recreation. So I definitely want to recreate an intro like this, something with really smooth velocity, a fun and bright background, you know, a cute overlay, so let's do that. So I have this clip, and I think I'm gonna do a bright blue background. With this, I'm definitely gonna add some hearts in the background, because I saw that she liked to do that. I'm definitely gonna add some rough edges around this, kind of give it that rustic aesthetic look. So I think this is super interesting, because as I'm doing this, I see that we use a lot of the same effects, but we definitely use them in completely different ways. So it's just really cool to see what different editors come up with, how like our brains work when we're making an edit, and how we can utilize the same skills but in completely different ways. So like I said, Vivian does a lot of masking with background, so just on my first clip, I started masking it, then I added a solid layer and I made that a little bit less opaque. Then I added this effect called auto paint to the background for some more texture. I also added a cherry blossoms overlay, and then I went up and I added a shape layer so I could do like an outline of him, and for this I decided to do dotted lines. And then after all of that, I pre-composed it together. And this was just the first clip of many. So for my next clip, I essentially followed the same process. I masked my clip, I added a background. I also added a four color gradient, not really necessary, but whatever. Then I added my overlay. I chose crosses this time. And then I decided to do a rotation transition. I usually do plus or minus 50, but like I said, her transitions are bigger than mine. So I went for a whopping negative 70. I know, such a big difference. I also noticed that her transitions weren't as fast as mine, definitely a different look. So I decided to switch up my graph, not bring the knobs as close together to get that slower effect. And then I added one of my shake presets, but I increased the value because I noticed her shakes are definitely more intense than mine. And then I decided to do a zoom out with fisheye warp because she does that a lot. And I struggled on this part. When I say I struggled, I kept adjusting the value. It was an absolute train wreck, but I think it ended up looking good. Maybe you'll see. So at this point, I'm on my third clip and I am tired. I am close to tears. Not really, but all of this masking is so much for me. I'm just masking, background, auto paint, overlay. It is just so much. Vivian, I don't know how you do it. There was also this voice in the back of my mind saying, Lauren, your fish warp from the last clip looks ugly. So I went back and fixed that for probably another 15 minutes, not gonna lie. I also added a strong horizontal shake and a skew shake because I saw Vivian did some skew shakes. Anyway, once I'm done with that, I decided to do like a split open transition. I saw that in one of your edits. So I did that. I added two clips under it. I had them slide in like Vivian did. And then I added this really sharp, strong horizontal shake to the first clip. And then to the second clip, I did a vertical shake. I literally just hit myself. So while you guys watch me compose this next clip, I'm gonna answer some common questions I get about editing styles and finding your own personal style. I've gotten so many messages from accounts just starting off, and they pose a genuine concern about not having a style within like a few weeks or a month of starting their accounts. In complete honesty, if you have a solidified style in less than a year of starting your account, you're actually a wizard or something, let alone within a few weeks of starting your account. Scratch that. If your first few edits are actually good, you may as well just contact the CEO of After Effects and steal his job, because that's so unheard of. To all beginner editors, you simply cannot compare your skill capacity to that of people who have been editing for years and years, such as myself. The only key to developing your style is time. You'll subconsciously catch yourself starting to repeat certain transition combinations that will naturally become the mold of your style. If you rush into Instagram editing with the impression that you should be as good as people who have been editing for a while, you're inevitably prone to self-deprecation and will feel unreasonably bad about yourself. Anyway, thank you for tuning tuning into my podcast. I'll be here next week. So while I work on my little 3D moment, I also want to talk about not having a style entirely and why there's nothing wrong with this. People have expressed to me so many times, you know, Lauren, I keep switching between photo and video edits and I always change my style. What can I do? But honestly, everyone's account needs some experimenting. I am constantly trying new things that may not necessarily follow my style, but the response from my audience is overwhelmingly positive. People like when you go out of your comfort zone and try new things. So in a way, not having a consistent style underscores your ability to think outside the box and your untamed creative range. Don't confine yourself to certain transitions just to fit into the mold of your style.
Okay, I'm back.
I'm not gonna lie, it's the next day. I finished the edit 24 hours ago, but I fell asleep, so we're back the next day. Also, I need to apologize for how bad I've been looking this video. It's been a long 2 days. I wake up at 7:30 and I'm on neuroscience conferences until 12, and then from 12 to around now, around 8, I'm on Hispanic scholarship student-related conferences. So yeah, it's a little day in my life for those of you who wanted that video. That's a day in my life, not very interesting, but let's just watch my finished edit.
I didn't add an audio because I couldn't choose one, so I'll just sing, oh, he's sweet but a psycho, a little bit psycho. At night he's screaming, my mama, my mama, my. I hope that's long enough.
I really adore Vivian's style. I think it is so smooth, it's so cute, upbeat, just very pleasing on the eye. So I hope I did her style justice. I know Vivian said in her video recreating my style, she was like, Lauren has so many effects in the background that you don't even see, but they're still there. Vivian, you have masking on all of your clips. You have a very detailed background on all of your clips. Like, I don't even compare to the amount of detail you put in. So that was a little bit challenging. Trying this style was very different for me, and I'm sure that my style was very different for her. But yeah, thank you guys so much for watching, and if you want me and Vivian to collab again in the future, which I'm sure we will, just leave a comment showing your support and we will make this duo happen again. I hope you guys enjoyed. Bye.